BN was founded in 1986 as Basic Income European Network. It expanded its scope from Europe to the Earth in 2004, and it's known today as Basic Income Earth Network. It is an international network that serves as a link between individuals and groups committed to or interested in basic income, and fosters informed discussion of the topic throughout the world. Let's have a look on a map in which countries affiliates exist and where discussions occur. The Basic Income Earth Network started in Belgium and has affiliates in these European countries: the Netherlands, Great Britain, Ireland, Germany, Austria, Switzerland, Spain, Denmark, and Italy. Basic income has a long tradition in the USA. A guaranteed income was a mainstream idea in the United States during the 1960s and 70s. Leading economists, including several who later won the Nobel Prize, endorsed it. An odd amount of this time exists in Alaska, where a national dividend is paid once per year. Let's hear what Niilo Koponen, a citizen from Alaska, is telling about.
The Permanent Fund Dividend was developed in the legislature as one way to make sure that Alaskans shared in the profit of the mineral wealth of this state. Children, adults, seniors receive their dividend in the fall. And one of the things that this does is to stimulate the local economy in the state.
Other countries in America with affiliates of BN are Canada, Mexico, Brazil, and Argentina. Australia has a local network too, as well as Japan. In December 2007, the European Anti-Poverty Network launched an EU-wide campaign for adequate minimum income schemes. Meanwhile, basic income is a topic in the European Parliament and matches the whole European Union. But let's ask Mr. Suplicy from Brazil why he is advocating basic income.
I want to find the way to eradicate absolute poverty, to build a just society, to improve income distribution, to have justice, and to struggle for the day when everybody may sit in the table of fraternity, like Martin Luther King said in I Have a Dream.
And there are adherents in other countries having the same dream. In Namibia, for example, they tested if this dream could become true. Some words about the Basic Income Grant Project.
Those lobbying for the implementation of the grant are hopeful and optimistic.
For me, the important thing is that the community really feel they got their dignity back and they've been valued as a member of society. I think that's one of the important findings, that they really feel they've been regarded as human beings again and not just left alone in their poverty.
It would take only 5% of Namibia's GDP to pay for a nationwide basic income grant. And two studies have shown that Namibia has the economic stability and strength to finance it.
The neighbor of Namibia, South Africa, has also an opinion about basic income. The Archbishop, Desmond Tutu, spoke some words for the 11th BN Congress, which was held in Cape Town in 2006. Here is a part what he said.
We stand at a historic crossroads. One road leads up to the higher ground of social equity and inclusion, human dignity, full economic participation, broad-based prosperity and growth. The other leads downwards to growing poverty and economic inequity, social conflict, increased joblessness, and pervasive insecurity. The high road involves time-honored values of solidarity, compassion, and care. The low road is characterized by selfishness and greed. It threatens the stability of our families and even our entire social fabric. We have a unique opportunity to wipe out hunger and abject poverty, to make sure that no one falls into absolute destitution. For perhaps the first time in history, we have the resources, the know-how, and the technology to make starvation and dependency relics of the past. But do we have the will?
Mongolia seems to have this will to introduce a basic income in form of a national dividend. Bian reported about this in one of its news flashes. In another one, Israel was mentioned. It is amazing that basic income is free of religions and ideologies, because Bian reported also about a proposal for Iraq, and that in Iran the presidential candidate from 2009, Mehdi Karoubi, wanted to introduce an oil dividend. Other countries which were yet mentioned in Bian's news flashes are Turkey, Chile, Uruguay, India, and Ukraine. And in January 2010, a first Congress on Basic Income was held in South Korea. As you can see, this is a global movement fighting against poverty and advocating social justice and freedom for all.